Hey, Dr. Bernard here. There's two known species of venomous spiders in the United States. For both species, a bite leading to severe systemic illness is rare. Let me say that again. Systemic illness from a spider bite in the United States is rare. This video is to teach about the medical side of cases like this. It's not about scaring people on spiders. There's simple steps to help prevent this from happening in the first place that I'll tell you about later in this video. A boy put on a pair of socks he left on the floor on a hot summer morning. This is what happened to his kidneys. Gigi is a 17-year-old boy presenting to the emergency room in a panic. He tells the admitting nurse that he tried to take a leak in the shower and what should have been urine was red that splashed everywhere. Earlier the day before, Gigi was in his regular routine. He was getting ready for one of his last days of high school. As a person, he wasn't the cleanest. His parents were always neat and tidy. They believed if your living space is messy, your mind is messy. If you can't control the placement of objects in your room, which is the one thing that you absolutely can control, then there's no way that you can control anything else in your life. Gigi couldn't be bothered. He would leave his homework in stacks on the floor, claiming that there was an organization amongst the chaos, that he'd only lose things when meddling mom and her trifling hands tried to clean it up. Whenever he'd change into his pajamas, he'd throw his clothes on the floor, leaving piles everywhere. He'd do his own laundry, but he wouldn't fold his clothes afterwards, and sometimes clean clothes would get mixed with the dirty on the floor. Gigi's dad would tell him, "You know, you probably have roaches and spiders living in there. They make a nest, they lay some eggs, they're gonna crawl all over you in your sleep, and they're gonna take a nice bite out of you if they don't first crawl up your nose and into your brain one day," he joked. But that day was now, and it wasn't going to be a joke. One evening, Gigi thought he felt a tickle on his skin in his sleep, and when he opened his eyes, he saw a brown spider crawling around in the sheets. In a panic, he cried out in fear. He caught it in toilet paper and flushed it down the toilet. He couldn't sleep the rest of the night, but it's just getting warm now and the bugs are out, he thought. As the days passed, Gigi cleaned himself up. At first, he would fold his clothes and put them away, but as time went on, he became lazy again and started piling his clothes at the foot of his bed and on the floor. One morning, Gigi was getting dressed for school. It was almost time for summer break. He picked out some socks from the pile of clothes on the floor. Immediately after putting on the pair of socks, Gigi felt a little sting on his right foot, maybe like he had stepped on a little rock that was inside. In an effort to not feel what he thought was the rock again, he started to change the way he walked. He didn't remember if these were clean or dirty, but as he put on his shoes, he felt the sting again. Shaking his foot and tapping the toe seemed to fix it. Walk different, feel no rock, easy fix, he thought. As the hours passed, Gigi started feeling like something was wrong. He could feel his heart beat in his right foot. He could feel just that one foot swelling. In the afternoon, when he took off his sock, he noticed that his foot was red and swollen. He didn't think a little rock could just mess up his foot like that. He threw the dirty socks back into the pile of clothes on the floor and went to bed. But when he woke up, he had a waffle for breakfast, and that waffle came right back up. The smell of the syrup made his stomach squirm in a way like never before. He stood up from his chair and felt a weakness wrap around his shoulders and felt gravity drag his stomach into the ground. He had the chills, but then his back started to hurt as he noticed that something was wrong with his breathing. Gigi noticed that the wound on his foot started to look weird. He didn't think that a small rock in his sock could just do something like this. As he picked out those socks that he wore yesterday from his pile of dirty clothes on the floor and turned it inside out, he found a brown spider leg stumbling out from a crushed body. Gigi's worst nightmare about his hygiene manifested in real time, that it wasn't a little rock in his sock, but that a spider had gotten in and bit him from the inside. Even though his foot hurt and was swollen and red and looked like a giant bruise, he still didn't think that this was a problem. Until he went into the shower at nighttime, Gigi panicked because when he urinated, he saw it was deep red at first before becoming brown like Coca-Cola. In a frenzy, he called for 911 and he's brought to the emergency room where we are now. At examination, Gigi told the medical team about the bite on his foot. He showed them the spider remains because he brought the sock. The lesion on his foot had a red, white, and blue pattern from a pale bruising. When the medical team looked at the spider remains, they saw three pairs of eyes arranged in a non-touching pattern with a violin shape on the body. The eyes of the spider and the knowledge of the geographic location where all of this was happening tells doctors that Gigi is suffering from a bite from Loxosceles RECLUSA, also known as the brown recluse spider. Typically, when a lesion like this appears on the skin, most people aren't going to see what caused that lesion. Unless you live in this region in the United States or in Central or South America, it's highly unlikely to be a brown recluse spider bite. Their name is recluse, and they're known to not be aggressive in the first place. Even if you do live in this area, a Kansas family once trapped 2,055 brown recluse spiders over 6 months in their house, and no one there ever received a bite that they knew about. It's not often that the spider is caught in the act and presented to the medical team to confirm that it is a spider bite, but sometimes it is. And in Gigi's case, they were able to confirm the bite, but something's wrong. Typically, early after the bite, a blister can form without pus. Usually, if these are accompanied with ecchymoses, which are skin discolorations due to bleeding underneath, that strongly suggests that an envenomation did happen when the spider can't be retrieved or identified. These can become an ulcer, and the tissue can necrose, looking worse and worse over time before healing over several weeks. This cutaneous loxosscelism, cutaneous referring to the skin, and loxosscelism denoting a pathological condition from the genus of Loxosceles, means that the spider bite is localized to the skin. But is it really? Loxosceles venom contains biologically active substances that the spider needs to survive. This should make sense. Spider eat bug, spider need venom that neutralizes bug. But it also has several enzymes, which are proteins, one called sphingomyelinase D. And this is what appears to cause most of the damage to human tissue. And humans have more tissues than just skin, bringing us back to GG. A blood test finds that Gigi has anemia, an meaning without, and emia meaning presence of blood. Red blood cells have a protein called hemoglobin. It's how they transport oxygen throughout the body. When hemoglobin is low, it could mean that parts of the body might not be able to get enough oxygen. And in Gigi, his hemoglobin was low. But why? Hemoglobin contains heme, something that has iron in it, and it's how blood transports oxygen. My second in-depth channel is named Heme Review, and it talks more about venomous spiders, link in the description below. Sometimes, a little hemoglobin is floating around freely in the blood. Iron can react with structures in the body causing oxidative damage, so it needs to be contained. And the body can do that because the liver makes something called haptoglobin that captures free hemoglobin, and this complex is destroyed in the liver. If haptoglobin levels in the blood are undetectable, that could mean that all of it has been consumed by hemoglobin floating freely around. And in GG, the medical team notes that his haptoglobin levels were undetectable. Looking further at the blood test results, the medical team noticed that the level of a substance that's released when red blood cells are smashed and broken were high. And this explains everything. His haptoglobin is undetectable. They were all consumed by hemoglobin released when blood cells were broken. And this hemolytic anemia, an absence of the presence of blood because those blood cells are getting smashed and broken apart, means that something terrible is happening to Gigi. He put on a pair of socks that he left in a pile of clothes on the floor. There was a brown recluse spider inside that sock. Pressing the spider up against the sock and the skin of his foot agitated it, caused it to bite him. In the aftermath, the venom from the bite didn't just result in cutaneous loxosscelism. The spider venom somehow also got into his bloodstream and caused systemic loxosscelism. As the spider venom activates some of the immune system, red blood cells get attacked and shatter. Hemoglobin spills into the circulation, and when it reaches the kidneys, pigments and iron deposit in, causing massive damage, leading to the kidneys shutting down from permanent damage, letting blood and hemoglobin to spill into the urine. If nothing is done about this, electrolytes can become imbalanced, leading to the heart to beat irregularly. Hypoxemia, low oxygen presence in blood, can cause other organs to start to shut down. This will lead to acid to build up in his body. Gigi's heart can then stop beating, but not before massive bleeding happens to him because an inappropriate amount of blood clots are formed in the small blood vessels. Is there anything that the medical team can do about this systemic loxosscelism? Maybe. Spider bites are the weird cases that come into the hospital. Strange looking lesion on the skin, but nobody knows what caused it, and the spider got away. Without actually presenting the spider to the medical team at the hospital, we can't say 100% for sure that what's on the skin is because of a spider. This is why we don't actually know how many real brown recluse spider bites actually become necrotic. Lots of times they don't. Lots of times people get these bites and they don't go to the hospital, so they're never reported. This means that cutaneous loxosscelism, the bruising and the ulcer and the skin necrosis, don't always follow a bite. And many times it just stops at the skin. The wound can look terrible, but no systemic illness will happen. On the flip side, sometimes the cutaneous signs and symptoms are mild, nothing more than a little bruising, but the patient's organs have completely shut down due to systemic loxosceles. So what happens on the skin can't predict what can happen to the rest of the body. Systemic illness from these bites in the United States is rare. Sometimes brown recluse spider bites are diagnosed in areas where the spider doesn't live because a skin lesion is there, and there's no way of knowing exactly what caused it. Very rarely, the spider is presented to the medical team, and it is confirmed to be a Loxosceles bite, and that spider may have been transported somehow to this non-endemic area. And it could bite someone when it arrives, but the number of moving parts in that sequence of events makes it unlikely. A kind of spider bite that can happen anywhere in the United States is from the female black widow spider. They can be found throughout North America. Black widow venom is a neurotoxin. It can cause the muscles to cramp. It can make the face and the eyelids swell up. It can make it hard to breathe while the heart beats uncontrollably faster and harder, and it can lead to stroke and seizure in the worst cases, which are rare. In the continental United States, lower 48, the black widow and brown recluse are the only two known venomous spiders. If you don't live in this region, which is where the brown recluse lives, there's only the black widow. And as scary as the black widow bites may be, there hasn't been any recorded fatalities from it since the early 1980s, when it started to be tracked. Daddy Longlegs is not known to be venomous. There's also a hobo spider. If you Google it, a website says it's venomous, but there isn't good evidence so far for it to be venomous in a way that causes illness needing urgent medical care, and that's documented in medical literature. For GG, when he got the bite the first time, what he could have done is used a cold compress, because brown recluse venom is temperature sensitive. Enzymes are proteins, and they can change activity and conformation based on temperature. But for his systemic loxosceles, there is no anti-venom, there is no antidote to the spider bite available in the United States. Central and South America have some anti-venoms, but their loxosceles spiders are related, a little different, and the bites are more common and can be just as severe, if not worse. If Gigi's red blood cells were smashed and broken apart, then he can be treated by replacing those lost with blood products. If his kidneys have shut down, hydrate him. Correct his electrolyte levels and prevent his heart from beating erratically so that acid won't build up in his blood and that hypoxemia won't happen, shutting down the rest of his organs. The spider venom is the underlying cause. With time, it'll wear off because more of it isn't being continuously added into his body. With supportive care and a lesson to clean his room, to fold his clothes and have them tucked away neatly in a dresser, to organize and fold his socks in a way where he knows what's inside and knows which ones are clean versus soiled, and to never leave any of his clothes in a careless pile on the floor while living in a geographic region endemic to the brown recluse spider, and to check his bed every night before he goes to sleep, GG was able to make a full recovery. Thanks so much for watching. Take care of yourself and be well.